morning, students. I hope you all are fit and fine. And I know that you all are very much excited to learn grammar today. Yes, in today's video, we will learn one of the topic of grammar. Now, before coming to that topic, I want you all to sit with your pen and a copy. It can be your rough copy also. Yes. So what you have to do in that is you have to write 5 lines about your best friend. Okay, and I will also do the same. Yes? Okay, then start writing and I will explain you this. Okay, so I think so. You all might have written that. Now, what you have to do is, as you have written that, first you will listen my lines, what I have written. Okay, like I have written about my friend Neha. Yes? So, what I have written is, Neha is a brave girl. Neha loves cooking. Neha is good in English. Neha likes to travel a lot. Okay? Now, you some of the lines like this. So, you might be thinking that why ma'am have again and again repeated the word Neha. Yes? It looks awkward. Yes? It sounds awkward. Awkward means it doesn't sound good. Yes? Because as we have learned in our smaller classes also, that we don't repeat the same word, same nouns again and again in each and every line. Why? Because it makes the sentences boring. Yes? So just to not repeat the same noun in every line, what we do is we use the word pronoun. Yes? We use the word pronoun. So today's topic is pronoun. So in this line, in these lines, how we will write is, like, Neha is a brave girl, she loves cooking, she is good in English, and she likes to travel a lot. Now, why we have used this she? Because we know that Neha is a feminine gender. So, for all feminine genders, we use she. For all masculine gender, we use he. Understood? So, today's topic, I will be explaining you more deeply. Yes, the topic is pronoun. Now, if we will divide this word pronoun, it can be divided into two parts. Okay, pro plus noun. Now, pro means what? Pro means for. Yes, and noun, I think so. You all know what is the meaning of noun. Yes, so pro means for. So, the word that is used for noun is known as a pronoun. Understood? Now, pronouns have exactly the same uses as nouns. It is used exactly in the place of nouns, and the uses are also the same. Instead of repeating names, we use pronouns. Understood? Now, here is one example. Reena goes to school. She goes by bus. Okay? So, here Reena is what? Reena is a noun. Okay? And in the second sentence, we can also write that Reena goes by bus. But we have written as she. Now, why we have written as she? Because we don't want to repeat the word Reena again and again in the sentences. So, we have used here she because we also know that Reena is a feminine gender. So, in place of Reena, what we have used? We have used the word she. Understood? Now, see, in the above sentence, instead of repeating Reena, the word she has been used. Therefore, she is a pronoun. Now, some of the common pronouns that we use are I, we, he, she, it, you, they, us, me, him, and her. These are the some common pronouns that we use in our daily sentences and all. Okay? Now, students, coming more deeper in this topic, pronouns, there are 8 kinds of pronouns. Okay? The first one is personal pronouns. Second one is reflexive pronoun. Yes. Third one is emphatic pronoun. Fourth is demonstrative pronouns. Fifth is relative pronoun. Sixth is interrogative pronouns. Seventh is indefinite pronouns. And eighth one is distributive pronouns. I will explain you this one by one. Okay. So, first we'll come to the personal pronouns. Now, personal pronouns, with the word itself personal, it comes like person. Yes, a pronoun that stands for persons are called personal pronouns. Yes, here we can say particular person, we can say like. So what exactly is this point of view? We can say that yes, it is divided into three parts. It is the first person, it is the second person and the third person. Okay, now let me explain you with a simple example. Ram and Shyam is in a room, okay, and they are talking about the girl who is rich. Something to Shyam about Richa who is not present in that room, then in this case Ram is the first person, Shyam is the second person and Richa is the third person. Okay, means the first person who is the speaker, the second person who is a listener and the third person about whom these two these people are talking. Okay, Ram is saying that I am telling you that she is very intelligent. Okay, I am telling you that she is very intelligent. Means here Ram is what? He is the first person, means I. Okay, Shyam is what? As he is listening, he is the second person, it means you. And about whom they are talking? They are talking about Richa. Okay, so she is the third person. Understood? Okay, now this personal pronoun is further divided. Okay, now it is divided into forms. Okay, now these forms are singular and the plural. Okay, now the singular, what this singular means? Singular means when we are talking about only a particular one person. Okay, one person or a thing. And plural means when we are talking about more than one person or a thing. Understood? Now moving further to the next division, this personal pronoun is further divided into subjective, possessive and the objective one. Okay, now subjective means when in a sentence it is used when we are addressing to a subject. Subject means a doer. Okay, it is used for addressing subjects, it means the doer in the sentence. Okay, now here the doer can be I, we, he, she, who, they. Okay, these are the examples of subjective. Now in possessive case, possessive means the ownership. Okay, used to show the ownership, like this is my book or this book is mine. Okay, so my means here this book is mine, means I am the owner of this book. Okay, so here my or mine is the example. Our or ours, his, her, hers, their, theirs and whose. These are some of the examples of possessive case. Okay, now coming to the objective case. Objective case is used when the object is addressed in the sentence. Okay, now this object can be a living, it can be a non-living thing. Okay, like me, us, him, her, them, whom. Okay, now this possessive case, as you know that a ownership can be only a living being. Okay, so here the examples are only of living thing. Okay, like mine. Yes, I hope you all have understood. Now we will just revise these partitions, okay, of the personal pronoun. The first one is three types of person: first person, second person and third person. The second division was two types of form, that is the singular and the plural form. And third one was subjective, possessive and objective. Now coming to the second topic is the reflexive pronoun. Okay, as the word itself says, reflexive, that reflects something. Okay, as you might have learned this in science also, reflexive. Okay, means which reflects something, reflects the subject. Okay, and how we can make a reflexive pronoun? We can make a reflexive pronoun by adding self or selves to my, your, etc. Okay, depending upon the number of the pronouns. Yes, like myself, ourselves, yourself, yourselves, ourselves, themselves, itself. Okay, it's all according to the singular and the plural. Okay, for example, he fell down and injured himself. Okay, now here in this sentence, what is the subject? Subject is he. Okay, now we have to make a pronoun which will reflect he. So for he, what we will be using? Himself, as we know that in this sentence it is a singular one. Okay, so for he we will be using himself. It means that he fell down and injured himself. Reflexive pronoun will be used only as an object. Okay, it will be used as an object, means it will be coming in the second part of the sentence, not in the beginning. Okay, so your subject is he and the reflexive noun made according to this he is the word himself. Understood? The second example, I enjoyed myself a lot. Okay, now in this sentence I is the subject. Yes, so as I is the subject, we have to make a reflexive pronoun in such a manner that we have to reflect that I. Okay, means I, what we will be making with I? Myself. As it is a singular, we will be using myself. I enjoyed myself a lot. So as a singular and plural, see, there are some words that is used commonly as a reflexive pronoun. For singular, myself, and for plural, ourselves. Okay, now this self will be used with singular, and with plural we are using selves. Understood? As in singular it is yourself, in plural we will be using yourselves. In singular it is himself, herself. Okay, and in plural it is themselves. Yes, in singular it is itself. Itself we are using when we are talking about a thing or a person whose gender we are not confirmed, like a child. We don't know whether it is a boy child or a girl child or any animal. Okay, so for them we are using itself as a singular, and for plural it will be themselves. Now the third topic is emphatic pronouns. Emphatic, it is also known as intensive pronouns. Okay, now in intensive pronouns, these are the pronouns used to emphasize or stress a noun or pronoun. Understood? Like these pronouns have the same form as reflexive pronoun, but they have a different function. Okay, like for example, I myself went there to inquire. There is a difference. Like this is always used with a noun or a subject. I myself, they themselves, you yourself. This, they are giving a stress to the subject of the sentence. Now the next is fourth one, demonstrative pronouns. Now, pronouns used to point out the objects referred to in a sentence are called demonstrative pronouns. Means in a sentence, wherever we are demonstrating or wherever we are pointing out, like this, that, these, those, are known as demonstrative pronouns. For example, that is a good umbrella. So here, that is a demonstrative because it is pointing out that is a good umbrella. Understood? This is a present from my brother. Okay, now in this sentence it is pointing out like this. So this is what? It's a demonstrative pronoun. Understood? So students, in this video I have given you the explanation about personal pronouns, reflexive pronouns, emphatic pronouns, demonstrative. Okay, now the other four types of pronouns we will be studying in the next video, in the next class. I hope you all have understood this much. Thank you.